Clearly, it looks like the cap will be lifted. How aggressively it will be lifted to be determined. What the oversight, I do sit on the state school board as treasurer, just default the lieutenant governor and the treasurer get appointed.
I was trying to connect the dots.
Yes. So the oversight of those charter schools, it's interesting currently, you know, you have the entire public school system with, you know, a million something kids in it, and then you have these charter schools, and they take almost as much time to oversee each charter. So there is a governance challenge. I think there's a big debate around where should you house that governance and how should it be governed, both for homeschoolers and charters. I think the Republican majority has said they would like that out of DPI. I think there's a lack of trust of DPI, and maybe they think it's, you know, overly, anyway, I won't even get into the whys because I can't project, but so how that will happen. Then the other is the finances. You know,
how it play on the budget.
Yeah, well, you know, of course, Skip Stam from Wake County, who's the majority Republican House leader, has wanted tax credits. They've called those vouchers. I mean, there's all sorts of, is there going to be some sort of financial incentive to have your kids in a charter or to... all of that yet to be determined, but obviously lots of ideas floating. I think that has been the mechanism over the previous years, where as they've written the budget and where they've directed those monies, that's where it's been embedded. Whether there have been statutory updates, I mean, I doubt it, but again, I haven't looked specifically. The auditor's office probably has to audit the lottery. I don't know on what timing or cycle she does that, but there'd probably be more information in there as well. So in terms of background, I started out as a stock analyst, actually in Hong Kong. So I lived in Asia for 3 years back when the Southeast Asia market was burgeoning, and I did public equities stocks. So I'd make the recommendations of buy, sell, or hold. I have an MBA from the Wharton School of Business, and then worked in more Fortune 500 kind of consulting, which has probably been, the treasurer's office is really a combination. You need to know investments. Obviously, you have a chief investment officer and a team, about 25 people who are investing money. You need to know enough to help them sort of do their job and hire the right people to do it. But it's also a very much of a general management job of rebuilding, you know, the organization. We have 400 people in the department, and there's across, you know, banking and unclaimed property. So that kind of Fortune 500 consulting has been very helpful working with large institutions. I was on the city council, 01 to 03 in Raleigh, which has been helpful on the local government finance. We also oversee all local government finance in the state senate, which is also very helpful since they write the laws that help oversee our department. And then now since 08 in the treasurer's office.